At 10:39 in the morning on January 16, 2003, a crowd of people had gathered to watch a space shuttle lift off. The Columbia lifted off, blasted off, I guess, into the air. It was not the Columbia's first launch. It had actually been used for 22 years, and in fact, it had traveled in space 27 separate times before. The Columbia was supposed to spend the next 16 days in space, and in fact, it did. Everything went smoothly. All systems were go. Science experiments were carried out on board. The crew members got along well and had a good time together. They emailed messages back and forth to Earth, keeping everybody up to date with what was going on. On February 1st, 16 days later, 2003, people gathered again, this time to welcome the Columbia back into, I guess, Earth's atmosphere. At 8:52 a.m., just a few minutes before the Columbia was supposed to touch down, things went terribly awry. And in fact, the Columbia blew up at 9 a.m., and President George Bush at the time announced later that afternoon, the Columbia is lost, there are no survivors. There were 7 astronauts killed that day on board. Rick Husband, William McCool, Michael Anderson, Kalpana Chawla, David Brown, Lauren Clark. They were all American. The 7th astronaut that died that day was a man named Ilan Ramon. He was the first person from the country of Israel ever to travel into space. Today, we are going to talk about his story. To truly understand the excitement about Ilan Ramon going up into space and becoming Israel's first astronaut, we need to do a little bit of math. In America, the current population is, forgive me while I look over, 311,591,917 people. In Canada, the population is 34,108,752. And in Israel, the population is 7,624,000 people. So you see the big difference in populations between America and Canada, between Canada and Israel. Israel is a really small country, and so the fact that there is an astronaut that has come from Israel was a great source of pride, and we'll talk about that in a little while, but I first want to get into a little bit of the background of Ilan Ramon. I also want to point out that Canada has had some astronauts as well. Depending on which website I looked at, it's anywhere between 10, 11, and 12 astronauts since the Canadian Aeronautics Program began in 1983. And I think there's something like 5 Canadian astronauts currently in the roster. So it's not one of these usual things, and the fact that Israel had produced Ilan Ramon was a source of great pride, and that's why when he died in the space shuttle disaster, it was such a hard hit for Israelis everywhere because he was a hero that we didn't expect to have. A Jew who had managed to represent Israel in a space shuttle who was tragically killed on his return.